of the great running backs here at West Virginia. Both of these young men are even more impressive human beings than they are football players, and it's going to be a joy to watch them tonight.
Larry Fitzgerald leading the country in four different receiving categories. He already has a record that he will try to extend tonight, consecutive games with a touchdown. Rob Stone's going to tell us how, if ever, you can cover him when we come back. Fitzgerald and the Panthers ready to take on the Mountaineers. We're ready to welcome the third member of our crew, Chili, tonight on the sideline, Rob Stone.
Thanks, Dave. West Virginia has devised a three-step program to try and limit Fitzgerald tonight. Number one, they're going to double-team him. Sounds kind of basic, but they're going to have some different twists to it. Secondly, they want to cut off his supply. They're going to cause havoc in Rod Rutherford, the quarterback's game, make him tentative and not sure of what he's doing. And thirdly, they're going to get physical with Fitzgerald at the line. It's something the staff told us that they haven't seen in the film lately this season, but Coach Curry, there may be a good reason why they're not doing that to Fitzgerald.
Yeah, there's a reason. It hasn't worked very well. Neither has anything else, but they are going to take a shot at it. They think their corners have a good chance to match up better that way against Fitzgerald.
Two of the best offensive minds in football matched up tonight, Walt Harris and Rich Rodriguez. Pitt wins the toss, defers. And we are underway. Adam Gressel's kick will not be returned. And after the touchback, West Virginia with Rasheed Marshall, the junior quarterback from Pittsburgh. Sat out last week, had a concussion two games ago against Central Florida. He had headaches about 4 days still after the concussion, but he says they've been gone for better than a week now, and a 14 Mountaineers from Western Pennsylvania. And less than 50% this year. What you're used to from a Rich Rodriguez offense, you're not going to see from this West Virginia team. They are much more threatening on the ground than they are through the air. And that brings us to Mr. Wilson, number three. And his first carry will for 3 yards. Our Bud Light starting lineup for the Mountaineers.
Chris Henry, number five, is thought by his coaches to be have the potential to be like Larry Fitzgerald, and I swear in practice Thursday, that's exactly how he looked. He has great ability.
So the hurry up is what West Virginia stays in basically the entire game. The first pass will carry across the 40-yard line for K.J. Harris, a gain of 18 yards. Junior out of Tampa, Wilson's backup. Here's the offensive front. And Sheffy gets a start for Dan Moses, who's learning a lesson about punctuality. He'll get in a couple of series later. Up front defensively for the Panthers, Harriet Allbig East led the conference in sacks last year. It's a veteran group for Shumas Stevens, both returning starters. And straight through the middle, knocked back after a pickup of three. Wilson hit by Lewis Morris and Tez Morris, the safety, Lou Moore, leads the Pittsburgh Corps of linebackers.
And Walt Harris told us that Lewis Moore is as good as any linebacker in America, plays sideline to sideline.
Now, when Gilliard gets a chance to tackle Quincy Wilson, they get interesting because Tyrone is dating Quincy's sister. Surely that won't matter.
There may be a word or two there.
On second down at six, K.J. Harris. And the Panthers have him corralled at the 43-yard line. Harris actually with a better yard per gain average than Wilson. He's getting them 5.5 yards per carry. He spent 3 years in the Rangers minor league system. Important for Pittsburgh to show they can handle the West Virginia running attack because Pitt has given up some record performances on the ground this year. Going deep, Marshall. And just overthrown with a flag now, Chris Henry. Shante Spencer had him one-on-one, and Henry draws the flag.
Take a look at the foot speed now. Chris Henry on Shante Spencer. And he has a burst, and he runs right by Spencer. Spencer's struggling to catch up. And the mistake he makes is, after the push, he gets a piece of the back of the legs, and that's what they called him for. It was a very close call, but he was beaten badly. Ball slightly overthrown, otherwise it might have been a completion. Chris Henry with speed and athletic ability, perhaps the equal of Larry Fitzgerald in the future.
Now that is a mouthful.
It is. If I hadn't seen it in practice, I wouldn't believe it.
Panthers don't get many flags. In fact, they get the fewest in the Big East. But this one keeps the opening drive going for the Mountaineers in Pittsburgh territory. Wilson with another flag down, unable to get the corner turn at the 41. Lewis Moore on the tackle may have a holding.
And this is where the lack of discipline hurts your team. Jeremy Sheffy starting in place of Dan Moses. Dan Moses being disciplined for being late to a meeting. And Sheffy gets the takedown and the hold, which is going to back his team up.
Holding against the offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Now, Rich Rodriguez's team, on the other hand, has had some problems with too many penalties this year.
Yeah, almost twice as many. They're penalized 77 yards a game. And in a game like this, you really can't afford it. You really can't afford those little things. And it was the little things that Rich Rodriguez thought probably should have cost him the Boston College game. But they came through because of big plays on special teams.
Their fourth straight win. Panthers also with four straight wins coming in. Get back some of that Shante Spencer penalty. Look at first and 20 back in their own end. Short toss this time and complete. Henry again the target. Sophomore Bell Chase, Louisiana.
Just a little taste of inexperience there. Chris Henry didn't need to put his knee down to catch that football, but he did. And that's why you heard the immediate whistle.
5 yards on the first and 20. Marshall on the roll. Looks up, uncovered is Henry. How does that happen? To the 25 of the Panthers. 23 yards. You think they would never lose sight of number five, but they did.
We'll check the coverage here and see how this could have happened. It's going to be a sprint to the sideline. Okay, here's what we see. It's a 2D. The corner goes with the deep man. You got Henry is hooking up in the flat where the corner should have stayed. Shante Spencer left his responsibility. That's what happened.
Mountaineers, as always, hurry to the line. Try to keep the pace as rapid as possible. And back on the ground, a hold this time, and Wilson shows his fight.
Now, we're not going to be able to show you many replays because West Virginia is at the ball so quickly. But you watch Quincy Wilson. The first man never stops him. He is so powerful. His legs keep churning. His pads are so low, he intimidates tacklers. Look here, whipping through arms, spinning, turning. He's still on his feet, making 4 yards after being hit by Brian Bennett, number 44.
Third and 10, first down, 8th play, the opening possession of the game. With his call after he checks the defense, and now for one of the few times up against the play clock. And Wilson up against a strong defensive surge by the Panthers and led again by their leading tackler, Lewis Moore. This is the scene of people still trying to make their way in here. Now, as we said, because of some earlier crowd control issues, they have more than doubled security tonight. And there have been, I'm going to guess, as many as 4,000 or 5,000 people trying to make it in through those end zone turnstiles to our left. Still at least 1,000 stacked up out there. Here comes up the middle to the goal line and in, Miquel Henderson, 18 yards and a touchdown.
Paul Rhodes, defensive coordinator for Pittsburgh, was worried about getting run over, but that was a skill drive.
A lot of finesse and not that much power needed on the opening possession. The extra point, Brad Cooper, 7-0 West Virginia. Henderson, Jr., Mobile, Alabama's second touchdown of the year, overcame a broken leg last spring. He was the leading receiver a year ago. It's given way to Henry somewhat, but he finishes this first possession.
misdirection screen, causing the fast flow linebackers to slip with excellent blocking, leads to the first touchdown. We're 7-0 West Virginia here in the early going.
And Pittsburgh stunned after 9 plays, most of them of that variety, a lot of misdirection, mostly finesse, and they went for a fake to Quincy Wilson that left nobody to lay a hand on Meekwell Henderson on the touchdown. Cooper with the kickoff. And Terrell Allen with an alley. Cooper, the first to touch him near midfield. He's still going, and they'll finally call him out. Back around the 41-yard line, a 53-yard return. And that's how long Mountaineer momentum lasts. As the Panthers get to take their first snap inside West Virginia territory.
There's some serious blocking and collisions going on there. Clint Session, number 17 of Pittsburgh, really nailed K.J. Harris, the fine running back, who's also an excellent kick cover, and opened up the big hole for the long return. Nice field position, better than nice field position for the Pittsburgh offense.
And Rod Rutherford leads out one of the top groups in the country, the best offense in the Big East. No game, Lusaka Polite. And a quick review of Henderson to the West Virginia touchdown.
When we talk about misdirection, we're talking about, okay, there goes Wilson. The leading tackler, Lewis Moore, is slipping as they come back the other way. Great blocking by Garen Justice, number 69, John Pennington, 86. Out in front of that quick screen, misdirection, slip screen for the touchdown.
Second down after no gain by Polite, and Rod Rutherford to the air, and it took him that long, 2 plays, to find Fitzgerald, and he should have the first down. He will, a gain of 11.
Fitzgerald reaches down, picks up Wiley, the linebacker, and helps him up after his first catch. That's the kind of guy we're talking about. I'm not just blowing smoke about his humility. He's an amazingly mature young man to go with his phenomenal athletic ability.
And Rod Rutherford may be the most improved quarterback in America, from about a 30% passer just a couple of years ago to all Big East last year. May very well make it again this year. Jawan Walker with the carry. Down to the 26-yard line. And a chance to check the rest of the Panther starters.
Chris Wilson, number 83. I think, and I'm starting to sound like a broken record, you don't hear about Chris Wilson. He's not highly publicized. Great football player, great speed, great hands, outstanding blocker. You're going to be watching him play about the next 12 years. He's a senior, number 83.
Probably anybody else's team but Larry Fitzgerald, he is the number one target. Walker to the 23. The Pitt offensive line has a lot of veterans, and Petiti, probably the most consistent again this year. All Big East last year. This is his 35th consecutive start. LeCart, Morgan, 3-year starters. It's a 3-3 stack. That's what West Virginia calls their unusual offensive or defensive alignment. Lenore, Wiley, Jerko, outstanding linebackers, and they will normally have 5 DB. So here's 3rd and 3. Plenty of time to go to the end zone, and a touchdown, and the streak continues for Larry Fitzgerald. His 18th touchdown of the year. His 60th consecutive game with a touchdown catch.
And did you see him spike the ball or wave it in the opponent's face?
He's been there before. He acts like it.
He gets there every week. He hands it to the official.
Maybe looking at this year's Heisman winner. David Abdul had a terrific freshman year, so-so, as a sophomore, but he bangs the extra point through. And in 5 plays, Pittsburgh ties it at 7. Pittsburgh decides to go for the field goal, and Brad Cooper knocks it in from 21 yards. Or West Virginia now 10-7 on Cooper's 8th field goal of the year. Transfer from Middle Tennessee State.
What confused everybody was they stood there and they were thinking, what are they doing? Well, they were going to try to take the 5-yard penalty to improve the kicker's angle. Pittsburgh refused the penalty.
Oh, and they're waving on the crowd.
Yeah.
Come on, fire us up. Finally made the obvious decision, and Cooper gives the Mountaineers back the lead.
This is a tough angle, but for a right-footed kicker to kick it from the left hash where that was is not nearly as difficult as the other side. For whatever reason, there's some little physical reason or reason of perception, right-footed kickers want to pull the one that's on the other hash.
Walt Harris has brought back glory days to Pittsburgh, his 7th year. They have won 22 of their last 28. That's their best stretch since 3 straight 11-win seasons back in the late 70s, early 80s. Something else continues. He's had the best receiver in the Big East 6 out of his 7 years. He has a knack of making sure he has got pass catchers on the field wherever he's been.
Well, he also just got a great job out of his defense because West Virginia down there in the red zone is tough. They score almost 70% of the time touchdowns, but Pittsburgh only gives up a little over 60% touchdowns, and they were able to keep them out.
So Sherrill only needing 21 yards tonight to get that latest Big East record. And his 2 catches, 1 for a touchdown, 34 yards. So 10-7 Mountaineers. West Virginia penalized with a delay of game when it appeared they had called timeout. They called it too late. Pittsburgh, as Bill suggested, declined the penalty. And they end up settling for the 3. Terrell Allen returning. 19 yards, and Rutherford and the Panther offense back to work. West Virginia said something interesting this week. Their approach to Fitzgerald was, let's concentrate on his distribution. First of all, let's make sure that Rutherford has as hard a time as possible getting the ball to Fitzgerald.
Yeah, let's attack his distributor. Let's get on him. They haven't gotten much pressure on Rutherford yet, though.
Mountaineer corners also said, we've got a little something for him. Well, Fitzgerald getting the better of it tonight. And another first down. Well, tomorrow night, one of the most anticipated Sunday night matchups in a long time is Bill Parcells returns to New England and faces his former pupil Bill Belichick as the Cowboys visit the Patriots. Sunday night football, 8:30 Eastern, and it will again be available in our stunning high-definition ESPN HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV, or the Dish Network. NFL Primetime presented by Miller at 7:30 Eastern gets it all started.
I got to tell you, those 2 bills add up to about $1 billion in intensity.
Fire to the snap. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
And an update from Matt Weiner.
All right, Dave, you guys getting an up-close look at Larry Fitzgerald. USC has a pretty good receiver of their own. Matt Leinart finds him. Mike Williams, touchdown. Trojans up 14-0 at Arizona. We're into overtime number 2 in Tallahassee. All tied up at 44 apiece. NC State gets the ball first.
Now Florida State missing its chance to wrap up the ACC by losing the Bowden Bowl last week. So first and 15, Panthers at their 31. Running room, Lusaka Polite, huge fullback, 245-pounder. He had their game-winning touchdown in the final minute against Virginia Tech. 4-year starter out of North Braddock, where the Panthers have gotten a great haul of talent in Walt Harris' era. Tutu Ferguson, Shante Spencer. Also from the same fertile recruiting grounds. On the second down swing pass, Walker met quickly. Looked like he had some room, but it closed pretty fast as Leandre Washington, who wears 52 but is a safety, converted linebacker, 5'11 and 215. Remember, five DBs is the normal look for West Virginia.
The thing about this defense for West Virginia that troubles Walt Harris is he said it's like going against a two-minute drill type defense from the very beginning. They rush with three a lot, and they'll have eight drop back there, and you just have to throw swings all night. So far, they've been getting it down the field, but not that time.
Mountaineers coming with a blitz, and again, the Panthers have it well protected, and another first down. This is the first catch of the night for Princel Brockenbrough, and it's good for 18 yards.
If you blitz the quarterback, then you better get there. Here they're going to send six, and they're loaded up. Look here. They got six coming in here, and everybody is protected. Nice job of protection by Pittsburgh, and their extremely accurate quarterback, Rutherford. 77% last year is right on the money with the football.
Rutherford going deep on play action. Fitzgerald, another one with the flag, but forget it. You can push him, you can hang all over him, you can crawl inside his jersey, and you can't keep him from catching the ball. 45-yard touchdown.
It doesn't matter how many games we have with Fitzgerald. It doesn't matter who's covering him. It doesn't matter what the defense is. If Rutherford very wisely throws it in his direction, Brian King was in pretty good shape. He didn't have perfect coverage, but pretty good shape. The free safety came over. He had to take him going deep. He's a little bit off. He nudges him. He gets the penalty. Doesn't bother Fitzgerald, who has the most incredible kind of concentration. Think of Jerry Rice. Think of Tim Brown, the great receivers you've seen in recent years. He can already do the things that it took them years to learn.
His role model, a guy he watched year after year as a Vikings ball boy, Chris Carter, Abdul, to make it 14-10. Well, that's 19 touchdowns on the year. Four behind Tony Dorsett in his Heisman season. And speaking of Heisman, Rob Stone will talk about Fitzgerald's candidacy when we come back. Marshall, who hit his first six, has now missed his last three. And it's K.J. Harris's turn with Wilson catching his breath. Not a whole lot of drop-off from Wilson to Harris.
Well, K.J. is also a powerful back with good speed. Not great speed, but good speed. He may not make quite as many long runs as Quincy will. Now, they're both in the game. And this is tough for the defense. They're the two backs in the shotgun.
Marshall directing the deep pattern wide open all alone and broken up. What a recovery by Tez Morris. Torrey Johnson, when Marshall signaled him deep, was 20 yards behind any defender, and the pass hangs up just long enough for Morris to get to it.
When you've got a blown coverage, all you can do is turn and run and hope for the best. Tez Morris does exactly that. And Rasheed Marshall, in an attempt to be so cautious, hung the ball up just a little too much. You need to lay it out, let your man run under it. And he tried to just hang it up because it looked so wide open.
Fans boo the replay. Obviously not a penalty. And here is a rugby-like quick kick effort out of the shotgun by Marshall. And does it ever work? It's going to roll dead inside the five. But you know what Rasheed is still thinking about is what might have been. He'll never have anybody more open than Torrey Johnson just was.
Torrey Johnson somehow got loose in the coverage. Number 44, tight end. He's being waved deep. You see him coming down the middle. He is so far behind the coverage. I can't even tell what the coverage was supposed to be. Tez Morris, a desperation run, two desperation plays by Tutu Ferguson and then by Tez Morris have kept the Mountaineers out of the end zone on that drive.
He was so open, he ran clear out of the picture for a minute. But the Panthers now backed up at their own 4-yard line. And they'll try to gouge out some breathing room, but Tim Murphy with his first carry. may not even get back to the line of scrimmage. Ben Lynch and a fired up West Virginia defensive front there on what may end up the last snap of the first quarter.
Well, we were curious about what Walt Harris's approach would be to this West Virginia defense. We don't have to wonder anymore. He's just loosening up that arm of Rutherford and wearing him out. He's giving him fits in the secondary. Being cautious down here in the shadow of his goal line.
Unlike earlier in the week, virtually no wind tonight. Murphy again fighting just to get back to the line on what is the last play of the first quarter. Well, we saw 222 combined passing yards. We saw 4 catches, 2 touchdowns, 90 yards for Larry Fitzgerald. 8 carries, 50 yards for Quincy Wilson. Fireworks. What else would you expect in the backyard roar? The Pac-Man is fun to watch.
He said his mom named him that because he ate all the time when he was a baby.
I bet he jittered around quite a bit. West Virginia with a scrambling Marshall out of one tackle, then brought down by Vince Krosciunas, the senior nose tackle. Kind of settled into a exchange of punts after the early offensive flurry.
Andy Lee must be disappointed with his performance so far tonight. The leading punter in the Big East, the leading special teams player a year ago, 44.8 yards, average normal, not tonight.
Not much blocking on the left side, and K.J. Harris gets slung down at the 42 by H.B. Blades. Monday Night Countdown presented by UPS. Providing comprehensive analysis, interviews, highlights, up-to-the-minute NFL news, live reports from the site of ABC's Monday Night Football game. All the news from the best in the business begins at 7:30 Eastern and leads up to Monday Night Football. An electrifying matchup this week. Terrell Owens of the 49ers, Hines Ward and the Steelers, two of the best receivers in the NFL. Live on ABC at 9 Eastern. On 3rd and 5, Marshall. On target to Henry, and a first down at the 49-yard line, right in front of Josh Lay. Game started with the Mountaineers marching down the field with the opening kickoff and getting a touchdown from Nequel Henderson, but Fitzgerald has come back with 2 more touchdowns and continues to add now to his new season Big East record for yardage. 16 straight games with at least 1 touchdown catch. Quincy Wilson throwing a sense of timing, and here comes a late flag. Blades in on another stop. Right in front of the West Virginia bench where they grab their imaginary face masks.
There is no penalty on the play. The player was grabbed by the shoulder, not by the face mask.
H.B. Blades, a true freshman, getting an increasing amount of playing time as the season goes on, and a great shot there at the correct non-call.
Yep, sad look to me, and that's what it was, and the officials wisely flagged it off.
Wilson gets 6, 2nd and 4. Wilson maybe couple through the middle this time. Watch for that play later as they fake the end around to D. Halston. Claude Harriott, who's still getting to the quarterback this year despite a nagging injury. His senior year, maybe not quite as productive as his junior year. First team All Big East, led the conference with 9.5 sacks. Still makes his presence felt though. Here's 3rd and 1. Mountaineers line up in the eye this time. Inside the 15, they finally have him at the 5. 37 yards.
The first man never tackles Quincy Wilson unless he's hit in the backfield. Number 7, Corey Humphreys, has a clear shot at him here, but you just can't tackle this guy. Look at his shoulder pads. He just bombs people with those pads. Bang, and he's down the field accelerating. What a beautiful back to watch.
Shante Spencer, Malcolm Cosell prevent the touchdown. Mo Fofana, the fullback, clearing the space for Wilson. Rodriguez says one of the most unselfish players he has ever coached. Senior fullback, unsung, but made that play go. And Wilson now to 96 yards on just 11 carries. First and goal from the five. Again, breaking tackles for the touchdown. Settling into what we hoped we would see and expected we would see. Fitzgerald versus Wilson. And Quincy shaking off a mild injury, coming back to go over 100 yards with 9:21 still to go in the half. More importantly, to give the Mountaineers the lead back. Cooper's extra point at 17-14. Nothing new for Quincy. Two key moments earlier. Number one would be against Miami. Still ranked in the top three at this point. Wilson, maybe the best run anybody will have this year.
Play of the year.
Hurricanes, however, come back and they get the game-winning field goal, 22-20. 2 weeks later, Mountaineers over number three Virginia Tech, the highest-ranked opponent West Virginia has ever defeated. And that has keyed the four-game winning streak, and Wilson's taking close to Mo Fofana. Usually makes good things happen. There's a delay with an injury on the field as we look one more time at the touchdown.
Here's the touchdown, deceiving speed. He's the kind of guy, he's built low to the ground, missed tackle by HB Blades there, because you see this block moving at you, and you don't think he's moving very fast, but he is smoking. He is a great back, and what a joy to be with. Don't know who that is down.
Lineman, but unable to get the second number. And Quincy Wilson, put it mildly, on a roll. Sixth leading career rusher here at West Virginia. Otis is proud. Otis Wilson, former Bear.
Ooh, Otis. Otis is a real man. What
That's
a football
his dad,
player.
And that is Dan Moses.
Moses is 76. Gosh, he was still upright when Quincy left him and left him in the backside of the picture. Somebody must have fallen on his leg. That's the only thing I can figure there. They seem to be indicating that his right knee is hurt. They were telling him to use his left knee, keep the weight off the right.
Moses really looked forward to this matchup. He's a redshirt freshman from Washington, Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh area. Wanted to play for the Panthers. They thought it was too small. And so we look forward to this opportunity to show them what they miss. He's up to 290 now. After a year spent redshirting, building himself up, and not even limping now as he heads off.
Well, obviously, he got hurt on the extra point. I don't, that wasn't very smart on my part. There's been a play since that replay we just watched. Somebody fell on him in the extra point, but he's walking. He seems fine now. That's all right. I'll wake up. She's ready. She's ready for this game to get on. Her team's back ahead.
Rain has passed through, hopefully not to return. Allen returns this one, and another good one. It up at the end, and they're going to say he was down before it was recovered by Corey Humphreys. A 49-yard return. You got to hold your breath on every kick return, every punt return tonight, not to mention whatever Larry Fitzgerald's on the field.
Yeah, veteran coach Bill Stewart handles special teams for West Virginia. He'll have some work to do on his punt kickoff coverage at the half.
Touchdown number one. What does he do? Hands it right to the nearest official. Now, He even has to chase down this ball. He's got to get away from a cameraman to get that ball over to the official. It is that much of an ingrained habit. Rutherford faking short and going deep. Double coverage flag. Still comes up with the ball.
Lest you think we were turning this guy into Superman and he's really not that good, that's the kind of play he makes every week. And when Dave said at the top of this game, you're going to see some catches that you've never seen before, this is what he's talking about. He's judging where the players are, where the football is, and there are three fine athletes there, Pac-Man Jones and Brian King. All three of them go up for the football. And just as surely as Bill Russell used to come down with a rebound, this guy comes down with a football.
That is ridiculous.
Yeah.
A human being does not make that
well,
catch.
Well, what if you were Brian King and Adam Jones? You think you'd feel even more ridiculous? That you can't even bat the ball out of his hand?
How strong his hands are, the impact with the turf, as hard as it was, does it not get loose? To the end zone. Talking about a hit, Chris Wilson takes one, and he hangs on. 17-yard touchdown for the senior tight end.
Chris Wilson, one of the best tight ends I have ever seen in college football. He has outstanding speed. He's a marvelous blocker. Right now, he's trying to catch his wind because Pac-Man Jones caught him right in the sternum, but he hung on to the football. I think he'll be fine. Wow, what a football game.
It's just, can you top this? And right now, the Panther receivers challenging one another. So after Fitzgerald's latest highlight play, Wilson.
Look at the left side of your screen. There's Chris Wilson, number 83, big tight end. All right, there's the catch. Here comes Pac-Man. It's going to be a big collision. Chris Wilson just concerned with putting the football away. He ends up in the end zone for the touchdown, and he's walking off under his own steam.
There are fewer and fewer of the Chris Wilson type tight ends in football. So when you have one like him, you really have a gem.
Yeah, Walt Harris knows that he's down there hugging on him too, and Chris is smiling. He just loves to play. He's back for his senior year. I'm sure he could have gone out last year.
David Abdul with the extra point. Mears' latest lead doesn't last long. 21-17. Third touchdown pass of the night for Rutherford. Wilson shaking it off. Doesn't matter how many times we watch that, we'll never believe it. But it was true. So they're ready from the 11, first down. This time has to keep and falls forward maybe for a yard. Ernest Hunter there with Ben Lynch this time. Tomorrow morning, Chris Berman and his crew with NFL Countdown presented by Old Spice at 11 a.m. Eastern with all their previews and John Madden's weekly feature right up until kickoff. Sunday NFL Countdown. These two sets of fans, as opposed as they are to one another, unite behind the Steelers. We have a Monday night date with the Niners. Rutherford, the end zone. Dropped by Lenore. And another sure interception that a defender can't hang on to.
Now watch his eyes here. This is a perfect job of coverage. They're rushing three, dropping eight, and this time it works. Another easy interception. Adam Lenore, the fine middle linebacker, can't come up with it. So Pac-Man Jones, Adam Lenore, two of the better defensive players, have dropped sure interceptions to help Rod Rutherford. And you don't need to help this guy if you're playing against him.
Third down. Floats that one and throws it away.
And this is the kind of thing that Walt Harris was talking about, that he doesn't like it when they drop eight. There's not much space down there inside the 10-yard line. Not many places to throw. You got eight blue shirts running around back there. You've just attempted a pass where you threw the ball right to the middle linebacker, so you get cautious and throw it away. So this time, West Virginia's strategy works. but only after they got into the red zone area.
So a 28-yard David Abdul field goal.
He's struggling this year, only about 50%.
8 out of 16. No problem with this one. And the Panthers, with 4:10 to go in the half, add to their lead, and it's up to 7. 24-17. Matt Weiner, what do you have for us at halftime coming up?
Well, Dave, coming up at the half, Oklahoma won by 77 over a team which beat today's opponent by 63. So did that mean the Sooners put up 140 on Baylor? Last season's number one was faced with yet another tight spot in Columbus. We'll tell you how the Buckeyes pulled off their latest escape job. Plus, tell you about a Wisconsin Badger who was unbelievable. That's not a tease for you. That's all coming up at the half, guys.
Watching Lee Evans today get 5 touchdowns for Wisconsin. Big 10 record. Surely you thought, well, that's the best receiving we'll see by anybody today.
Well, maybe I'll tell not. I'll tell you. The way he played today, and he's 100% well for the first time since he hurt his knee, he looked like Fitzgerald with another step of speed. That's what Lee Evans, if you can believe it, because he can just fly, that Lee Evans.
Back and forth. Mountaineers led early by 7, now trail by 7.
Let's see if one of these kickoff coverage units can get the job done and prevent a long return.
Adam Gressel, true freshman, had a terrific year. Almost half his kicks have gone to touchdowns. Not this one, though. K.J. Harris returns it. And yet again, breaks it big. Flag back around the 25-yard line. Harris out at the 48. 43 on the return as we wait for this indication. What is with the coverage team tonight? They're just getting shredded.
They are getting whooped, Dave. People are getting out of their lane. They're not paying attention to lane integrity. You know how I feel about that.
You're big on lane integrity.
You got to have lane integrity, meaning everybody stays in the lane that it's been assigned to them, and you don't get blocked. If you do get blocked, you bounce right back into your lane, and you don't allow these long returns. West Virginia continuing to hurt themselves with the penalties. Instead of being out near the 50-yard line, they're going to start at the 18 because of a holding penalty. Number 40, Mike Henshaw, detected holding on the return.
So Wilson and the Mountaineer offense back to work. Wilson was over 100, lost a couple. He's at 99 yards on 13 carries. Barely back to the line of scrimmage. Track it heads with Moore and Postel down to Rob Stone.
Well, Dave, Mike Watson, the big offensive tackle for West Virginia, back out on the field. He's playing, we're just going to call it a left sprain, because it's his whole left leg is sprained. He's got a left knee sprain and now a left ankle sprain as well. All occurred on that same play, but they're telling me the ankle is worse. They retaped it during that last series. He's back out there.
That's a tough guy. You think either one of those might keep him out?
Guy's an offensive lineman. You got to play.
Not allowed to have a hit, knee, or ankle. Bump fake, Marshall keeping. Looks like it might go big. Lewis Moore again. With the reaction of middle linebacker. Their leading tackler moving this year from the strong side to the middle. And they've been into Paul Rhodes, their coordinator, as good as any linebacker in the country, sideline to sideline. We've seen that. You can't really run away from it.
They'll run you down. Good player.
Hobson line it up for the 3rd and 6. One-man rush, swing pass. Couple of blockers out for the first down to the 34-yard line. Again, Moore on the tackle. Wilson, 11 more yards, and this time through the air.
In big games, great players make great plays. Quincy Wilson popping tackles, running through people. Watch him secure the football as the tacklers approach. He had an early game where he fumbled a couple times. He's never forgiven himself, and now he wraps that ball up. Just made the most recent first down on a nice screen throw.
Senior, who grew up early on in the Chicago area. Another burst, close to a first down. Rich Rodriguez said he's really the first downhill runner he's ever had in his system. This system's had a lot of guys who can get to the corner, but never somebody as powerful and as direct into the heart of the defense as Quincy Wilson.
Well, watching tapes of him, he's actually the kind of guy that you see tacklers start to shy off. They don't want to get hit by him. He's a punishing runner.
He did get the 10 in the first. And out of the eye, Harris takes a turn and gets across midfield. It's about 8. Cleared again by Mo Fofana. Mo is pretty hard to get a word out of, other than hi and bye. Nice to meet you, but he's
well,
a pretty good comfort out there.
He did say, make my sandwich to go.
Something I'm guessing he said quite a few times in his life. He only gets maybe a quarter of the plays. He has not touched the ball all year.
I asked him about carrying the ball, he just laughed. So I don't worry about that.
Second year starter, though. Harris will have the first down at the 45-yard line. We're under a minute and a half as the Mountaineers, with all three of their timeouts, a good chance, based on the start for this drive, possibly to go into halftime all even.
And Mo Fofana coming off the field now. We're talking about number 46, the big fullback, when we talk about Mo. Heck of a blocker. He's the best blocking fullback I've seen this year.
.45 actually, you see him without pads, believe it or not, looks low. Marshall wide open, Wilson. Coverage mistake, and he gets about a dozen more yards out of it. Ryan Bennett finally gets to him. So Wilson showing his versatility, not just a runner.
Very nice variety in play calling, slipping Wilson out in the flat. They're dropping in the zone. Lewis Moore coming inside out. Can't get there. I'm sorry. That's Brian Bennett, number 44. Wilson wisely stepping out of bounds to stop the clock with 59 seconds. All their backs catch the ball beautifully. I watched them in warm-ups. They're hand catchers, all of them.
Wilson averaging 113 yards per game. He's at 178 twice. Better than that pace tonight. No gain here. The 34, Ozzie B in there to drive him back.
And that's the way to deal with him. You've got to hit him in the backfield before he gets on track. Ozzie B coming off the corner, nobody to account for him. And the reason there was nobody is because Marshall could not get his Z, the wide receiver, to come in motion. He pumped his leg 3 times. Whoever was in at wide receiver was supposed to come in motion and block that edge player and did not get it done.
So the Mountaineers with their first time out. Speaking of the Mountaineer, the mascot of the Mountaineers, Rob, have we cleared up the story about going to the backup mascot?
Yeah, I got you here. There was no QB controversy. Rather, it was mascot mayhem in Morgantown. You know, starting Mountaineer, Trey Heinrichs, he had an emergency appendectomy this week, and they weren't sure if he could carry on with his duty so quickly. Backup Derek Fincham, with no big-time game experience, was thrust into first-team practice. But the doctors told Heinrichs before the surgery, hey, because you're in such good health, you will probably be able to go tonight if the surgery goes well. And he is. He's wearing the raccoon on the noggin. He's got his musket ready to go. The only thing he can't do today, can't do those push-ups when they score those points. I know he's upset about that.
Well, he's got the look down.
Well, ask him if he can far that forearm he's got down there.
I'm not sure that would be that good an idea. I mean, considering the height and security and all.
I'm
betting the thing's not even loaded. Just his presence is enough. Second and 10, 2 timeouts. Still remaining for West Virginia. 34 the Panthers. Marshall floating one for Henry and can't quite get to it.
And the reason he couldn't get to it is because his protection broke down terribly. Jake Holthouse, number 93, was clean in the backfield, just popped it through the A-gap, meaning between the guard and center. And Jeremy Hines and Dan Moses, the center and left guard, simply didn't get it done. Pass is thrown out of bounds. Chris Henry never had a chance to catch it. Got to keep those quarterbacks clean.
Panther defense coming in was less impressive than West Virginia's, but they've had a lot more luck getting to Marshall than the Mountaineers had getting to Rutherford. So third and 10. They come with a blitz. Marshall. Knocked out by Ferguson at the 28.
Good job of blocking by number 83, McQuell Henderson there on Tez Morris. This is one of the things that's frightening about Marshall. If you're going to pressure him and you're in man coverage, if he pops it on that blitz and somebody like Tez Morris does not make the play, then he's going to go down the sideline in the end zone.
This will be timeout number 2 for West Virginia. So if you're Pitt, and you're thinking, we'll go for it on fourth down, you just toss it Larry Fitzgerald's direction. West Virginia does not have that luxury, and they have 4 yards to go. They could try a Brad Cooper 45-yarder, but his longest this year is 43. And you'd expect them to go for it here down 7.
I think with Rich Rodriguez's offense, I think you run the ball here, or you have some sort of Rich Rodriguez play. Now, here's the previous play. They're coming with the blitz. They're in man coverage. And if he pops this, if the free safety can't get to him, as he does right here, and hold him to just a 7-yard gain, he's gone. And that's the risk in blitzing a guy like Marshall.
What about the freeze play?
Well, they tried the freeze play early in the game. The freeze is designed with a hard snap count, hoping that the defensive line will jump. If they do jump, the center will snap the ball, and the offensive line will simply sit in place, and you walk off the penalty against the defense. They tried it a couple of times early. Pitt didn't bite. They may try it here again. If they don't jump, then you go ahead and call the play and execute it.
And you get a freebie.
You get a freebie if they do jump. Let's see if they try it.
Mountaineers go 4 wide. Run back, Marshall shotgun.
They did not.
And with the pump and the deep ball, it is caught! John Pennington with the 28-yard touchdown. Everybody looks like Larry Fitzgerald tonight.
And Malcolm Postel. It's a mismatch. That's what Rich Rodriguez does so beautiful. John Pennington, a wide receiver, got on the strong linebacker, number 6, Malcolm Postel. And you get a perfect throw because the pressure didn't get there. A wide receiver on a linebacker and a fantastic throwing catch. Wow.
Cooper to tie it with the PAT. John Pennington, a junior who has, with that catch now, a total of 5 all year. And that's his first touchdown. But that's as good as anything we've seen from Larry Fitzgerald tonight. He might be the 8th weapon you would be worried about if you're the Pitt defense.
Here they come with the blitz. They're bringing 6, but nobody gets close. The rapidly improving Rashid Marshall, when I say improving, I'm talking about his accuracy, lays the football in there absolutely perfectly. It's either going to be caught for a touchdown or it's not going to be caught by anybody. What a nice job. And Dave, that weapon was far, because I heard it.
Hope it was a blank.
So did Ken Trevor, our spotter. And he spelled rifle, R-I-F-E-L. He's a Georgia Tech graduate. He's trying to spell musket now. He got that right.
Well, everybody Marshall and Rutherford have tossed it to tonight has been a weapon. Even little notice, John Pennington. And he was not listed among the top 7 wide receivers coming into tonight's game for West Virginia.
You know,
time to reload.
We said it was a mismatch with Postel, but Postel had good coverage on him. He was right with him and made it. He made Marshall make a perfect throw.
From here in Charleston, what a thrill that is. He ties it with 31 seconds to go in the half. Or from here in West Virginia, I should say. Charleston, downstate. Low bouncing kick, returned from the 4. Allen, for the first time tonight, runs into good kick coverage.
He also dropped the ball, and West Virginia has it. I think they're going to call him down. Abraham Jones on the hit.
And two flags down there to sort out as well.
Good ball. Personal foul. Get you down.
Now that's our first personal foul penalty, something that you always watch for in an emotional rivalry like this one. Hopefully our last. Obviously no fumble, obviously a good call.
Well, they call that a personal foul, but whoever made the hit thought that the guy picked a fumble up. He was trying to tackle him. Even that personal foul wasn't intentional. This has been a good, clean, hard-fought football game. The hope in the community is that's the way it'll stay with the fans and everybody. Players are setting a good example. They're going to run this clock down.
Could you ask for much more?
I don't know who's booing. I don't know if you could ask for anything more. You said it best, Dave.
580 total yards, 48 points. Oh, a dozen or so highlight plays. Somebody that's ready to go to New Orleans or Honolulu or wherever West Virginia may end up. And let's go down below to Rob. Started. Now they got it going. Wilson dragged down by one man. A real rare sight. Tez Morris, the safety in this case.
Yeah, and Quincy Wilson is sick about that. He can't believe one guy got him on the ground. Now he got caught from behind with an ankle tackle, a desperation by Tutu, and he gets dragged down by Tez. So Tez and Tutu, the safeties and corners respectively, saving these touchdowns.
Another long night. In terms of run defense or lack thereof for the Pitt defense. A continuing sore spot for them this year. Second out and two. And again, Morris comes up for the initial hit on Wilson. Not before first down to the 12-yard line. This Pitt defense has given up two school record rushing performances this year. Julius Jones got 262 for Notre Dame. Kevin Jones got 241 for Virginia Tech. And he scored all four Virginia Tech touchdowns. They allowed Notre Dame to run out the final 9 minutes of that game. They could never stop it.
What we're seeing here is a reversion to form. West Virginia just pounding the ball.
Quarterback draw, Marshall. Two good blocks and all the way to the end zone untouched.
And what a great job by the big guy, Mike Watson, who had to leave the game earlier. Back in there and sustained a block forever on Malcolm Postel, number six. A misdirection, and this time it did work on the swift linebackers for Pitt. Misdirection, boom, right back over here. Now a great job by Ryan Thomas, number 81, and watch 75 on Postel. Big Mike Watson. Mike's feeling much better with his sprained left side.
Well, there is also a personal foul on Pitt after the touchdown. That's our second personal foul penalty tonight of the Panthers. West Virginia with another chance to go on top by seven. They got the first score of the first half on the catch and run by Miquel Henderson. His 28-yard catch and run, a big part of this scoring drive, and they again lead by seven. And Rasheed Marshall, who reminds a lot of folks around here of Major Harris from the same high school in Pittsburgh, gets this trended play for the Mountaineers. 6:53 of the third, 31-24.
For the first time today, we see a real Andy Lee punt, 47 yards, hung up. The coverage has been excellent all year because net punt for this team is 41.1, which is among the nation's leaders. This time, Lance Frazier pops it. Excellent blocking, escorted down the field, and finally that piano fell on his back, and he got tackled at the three.
They thought he'd been close to breaking one all year, and it's finally happened. It's first and goal at the three. Quincy Wilson. He is corralled by J.J. Horn at around the one-yard line. What's really odd about the great return work we've seen really by both teams tonight is that West Virginia, the last three seasons, had had one punt return of over 20 yards. Combined, all three seasons.
Well, they got another one now. Yep, got some cramping down there, but that's worth the cramp, Lance.
One-yard line, second and goal. The eye and two tight ends, and Quincy Wilson stretches and gets the touchdown.
Quincy Wilson never gets tackled by the first tackler. Mo Fofana, big 46. We'll show you when we come back after the break how the big man blocks. Tough combination.
First time either team is led by more than seven tonight. And with a Cooper extra point, West Virginia by 14. Tough to keep up with the Larry Fitzgerald show tonight, but Quincy Wilson's coming pretty close. Second and 10, Lenore picked up, this time blitzing, and Rutherford with all day. Still cannot connect with Fitzgerald. Well, to get you ready for the NFL schedule, culminating tomorrow night with the Cowboys at the Patriots, Sunday Night Football. Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by Old Spice at 11 a.m. Eastern. They will have plenty to cover. Cowboys-Patriots, Monday night. The Steelers and the 49ers match up, and everything else there is to talk about in the NFL. West Virginia authorities more than doubled the normal security, hoping that the show of force would keep people in the stands, off the field, away from the havoc that was caused by an earlier big win. We hope that's the case. There are some not very pleasant signs going on here right at the moment. Brinsell Brockenbro, the catch, and gets 26 yards out of it. Under 4.5 minutes. Pittsburgh had won four straight, as had West Virginia coming in. They were at 7-2 with a bullet on the rise. Second straight year they had started 4-0 in conference play. Rutherford way over Walker. Back for an update again, Matt Weiner.
All right, Dave, we told you about Texas Tech taking the lead in Austin. It took Chance Mock about 10 seconds to get him back. B.J. Johnson on the other end of that touchdown pass. Horns back up by one.
Interesting that Chance Mock led that drive.
Yeah, but they left too much time on the clock.
They
There's
might
still
have.
46 seconds. It's too much with Texas Tech on the football field.
Mock more the passer, Vince Young more of the runner, and Mock maybe keeps the Texas streak going. Pittsburgh just trying to get something on the board in the second half. They've been whitewashed, 28-0 after a 24-all tie at the half. That one broken up out of the hands of Brockenbro by Adam Pac-Man Jones.
One of the criteria that inevitably gets in the minds of the voters for the Heisman is how well the team plays. This loss, I think, is going to make a big dent in Larry Fitzgerald's Heisman campaign. Well, I know it. I know it will.
Even
with facts of life.
With these numbers, 9 catches, 185 yards, 2 touchdowns?
Yep. It's just sometimes it's a subliminal thing, but the team has to be an outstanding team. No more do you win the Heisman with a losing team. Paul Hornung did it back in 56. That's the last time.
Well, this is not going to be a losing team.
Yeah, but in the perception, if you come down the stretch and do not win in your big rivalries, then somebody who does win, somebody like Jason White, is probably going to get it. I'm just talking about reality. It's not fair, but that's how the voting tends to go.
They're two games at Temple, home against Miami. And then the Bowl. Rutherford again harassed into an incompletion intended for Polite. Well, anybody who has seen him in action tonight, and even if they only see three or four of his catches tonight, will have to come to the conclusion that you haven't seen anybody more spectacular in college football, more unstoppable. And that's to say nothing against Jason White, who's the best player on the best team, and usually that's enough for the Heisman.
Yep. That's just the way the voting tends to go. Whoever gets it out of that top group, whether it's Larry or Jason or Eli Manning, maybe a couple of others that could come out of the blue and do it like Carson Palmer did it last year, any of those guys would be deserving.
Going for it on 4th and 10. Juggling catch, polite, and he's got the first down and still on his feet, and it's 1st and goal, Panthers. And 23 yards on the catch and run as we go under 4 minutes. Introduced at Iowa earlier this year, the collapsible goalpost, and I would predict that this will be standard equipment everywhere in college football very soon.
Yeah, the kids think, gee, it's okay. Everybody does it. We can all run out and tear down the goalpost. No consequences. Well, kids have been paralyzed. Spines have been crushed this year by falling goalposts. It is not an innocent, fun thing to do. When I saw that at Iowa, I thought, good gracious, we should have been doing this for 40 years. I've always been terrified that those things were going to hit somebody. And I've read about paralyzed teenagers because of it.
This stoppage is because of debris on the field.
Well, it only takes a few sick people to mess it up for everybody else. And maybe there's going to be some of that. That's a shame. We had one of our cameramen last year hitting the head with a bottle at another stadium. It's inexcusable.
First and goal. And a touchdown for Chris Wilson. And the Panthers' only points here in the second half by their terrific senior tight end, Wilson. In the wake of Larry Fitzgerald, 4 catches, 45 yards, and 2 touchdowns.
When I said that Pittsburgh was dangerous, Walt Harris, when the spread was 21, well, the spread went to 28. Now, just think, if it were down to 14 here and they could onside kick with 3 minutes and 50 seconds left on the clock, if they hadn't let Quincy get loose on that last touchdown run, we'd still have a football game.
Abdul for the extra point. 21-point game, 52-31, 3:49 to go. This first half as spectacular as any Bill or I have ever seen. Big play after big play. Unbelievable catch after unbelievable catch. Not all of them by Fitzgerald. So 24 all at the half, and we kind of expected, what will they have for us in the second half? Well, West Virginia had
some
a
D.
Lot more.
Had some D.
And they had some Q.
Yep. Had some D and some Q. You're exactly right. They were minding their D's and Q's. Great job on defense by Coach Castillo's unit, led by Adam Lenort, Grant Wiley, Ben Lynch.
Some of the stuff that Fitzgerald seemed to inspire in the first half. First Wilson touchdown. That touchdown, the improbable first touchdown of the year by John Pennington, every bit as good as anything we saw from Fitzgerald. Like that all 30 minutes. And I guess it would have been impossible to follow up on that. So West Virginia has gone just the old-fashioned football. Stop everything Pittsburgh has. They have figured out Rutherford with 3 sacks and 3 interceptions in the second half. And the Panthers have never figured out Quincy Wilson, who's at 208 yards, 4 touchdowns on his career night.
That's right. And another thing, what happened to Rod Rutherford, not only did he have the 3 interceptions, but he had a lot of overthrows and a lot of underthrows. He's normally incredibly accurate. This guy's a 61% passer for the year. He's had a marvelous career.
And you know what we're talking about? A guy who has had 419 yards tonight and 4 touchdown passes.
Right.
And they've solved him in the second half?
Well, in a manner of speaking.
Setting up for the onside kick, Adam Gressel. For the big hop, And it goes right to Mountaineer hand. Jerko with 3:48 to go.
We'll take another look at this outstanding defense in the second half. There have been people in Rutherford's face all night, either knocking him down or forcing him to throw on the run. A sack there by Kevin McLean. And when you got that kind of heat, it doesn't matter how good you are, you just cannot play your game. You're getting hit every time you throw the football, or you're trying to throw on the run, and that's not your strong suit. When he was allowed to stand in the pocket in the first half, he was magic. He was 3 touchdowns, 12 out of 19. 250 yards.
Part of a fifth-year senior class that was recruited when the Panther program was really in the depths. After a 2-9 season in 98, K.J. Harris with the carry. Walt Harris came up with Polite, Wilson, Harriet, Moore, and Rutherford. And this team will go to 30-17. They're headed to their fourth bowl. And they have, as a group, completely turned around the direction of the Pittsburgh program.
Well, coming into this game, they were 22-6 in their last 28 games. That's a winning percentage of 78.6%, the best span of that length in two decades. 11-3 in their last 14 games. So this is a great win for West Virginia.
This is a blow for the Panthers, but it does not finish them. There's too much football still to be played in the Big East. Harris with the first down.
Well, great job by K.J. Harris of getting on the ground. You see him plant his foot, turn, and fall down so he didn't go out of bounds. Keep that clock running.
What the Panthers still have left. They go to Temple. They have Miami at home. The Mountaineer fans, for one of the few times ever, will be rooting hard for Pittsburgh because they need them to knock off Miami. Give Miami its second conference loss and get them out of a tie with West Virginia because they beat West Virginia 22-20.
Now, this may sound silly, but I think Walt Harris should use his timeouts here.
Harris stopping, starting. Turns a no gain. It would pick up a 5. West Virginia the rest of the way. They'll go to 6-4, 4-1 in the league, a 5-game winning streak. And they go to Syracuse and finish at home against Temple. So a possibility to finish 8-4. Maybe repeating their record from last year, 9-4. When they finished up in the Continental Tire Bowl.
Okay, Walt Harris is using his timeout. He's going to take a 30-second timeout. Whether or not they have a chance to get back in this game, he's making a statement to his squad. We're going to use every resource to our dying breath to try to win the football game. You're never out of a game until the final gun sounds. If you leave those timeouts on the board, I really believe your team looks at you funny. Well, Coach, you didn't think we had a chance there at the end. So I think it's very wise just making a statement to his football team. Go ahead and use all three timeouts.
Both teams left with two. Once again, Harris. And it'll be 3rd and 2. Harris now with 11 carries, 40 yards, backing up Quincy Wilson's best night ever. Second time out here. 2:23. West Virginia's losses, with one exception, have all been winnable games. They lost by 7 to Wisconsin. The one you really scratch your head over is a 2-point loss to Cincinnati. We said they lost by 2 at Miami in the closing second. And by 27 at Maryland, the only team that has really handed it to the Mountaineers all year.
But they really felt like they found out about themselves at Miami. They knew they were as good as Miami after that game. Even though they lost, that was the turnaround in the minds of the players and the coaches.
Harris trying to run out the clock, and he'll move the chains again. First down inside the 30.
Really nice job of being the field general out here tonight by Rashid Marshall, number 2, the quarterback for West Virginia. He understands the system very, very bright young man. Another guy, one of our lunch mates yesterday, who sat there and explained the offense to me, told me what he was looking at when he turned to the sideline to get the signal, really helped me to understand what West Virginia was doing.
What West Virginia continues to do is dominate the run game like you will almost never see. The run comparison tonight, you won't believe. West Virginia, 294 yards on the ground. Pittsburgh, 10. That is, what, a 30-1 ratio? My rusty math.
It's a big one.
297 now.
And then you got Pitt with 419 yards passing, 216, and that shows you the relative merits of the run to the pass in scoring most times, not always. Yet another good back down there, Jason Colson, number 24 for West Virginia, who's also a fine-looking football player.
I wish they'd give it to Mo Fofana one time.
Mo deserves
give
a carry.
Give Mo a carry and touch the ball. All year, the senior fullback. It does all the heavy lifting for Wilson and Harris and Colson.
When I mentioned it to him yesterday, how about getting a carry? He said, oh, no, I don't even think about that, Colson.
Grant Wiley was ready to kick this thing off at noon yesterday.
I think he was. That's that linebacker mentality.
This is what he dreamed about, and it has come true. Another Pennsylvania product from the Philadelphia area. And another first down as they continue to prepare for the celebration, hoping it is just a happy, peaceful celebration.
Well, again, I cannot say enough about the way the players have conducted themselves. There's been no showboating. There's been no taunting, no fist fights, no cheap shots all night long. The players have handled themselves well. Now the fans can do exactly the same. This will have been a great, great victory for West Virginia.
No need to snap it again. West Virginia from a 24-24 halftime tie to a 52-31 win in the backyard brawl. And serious hopes of a Big East championship after giving the Panthers their first conference loss of the year. And you look on the field, Bill, and you see players and coaches, and only players and coaches,
it
and hopefully it'll stay
wonderful.
That way. And you also see Rob Stone, who was down there with Quincy Wilson.
Quincy, you first words and the first person you sought out was Walt Harris. What did you say to him?
Hey, well, we had a little thing that happened at the Big East meeting. He was talking about my sister dating somebody. He was picking on me a little bit. So I made sure the first guy I seen was him.
How big of a statement game was this for your program today, putting it to Pittsburgh at home?
Hey, we just do what we can, man. It was a big game because it was our next game, you know. It doesn't mean it was a pit or nothing, but we just wanted to go out there and play how we can. We played a great game today.
At what point did the staff come to you and say, Quincy, this is your game to win or lose for us?
They say that every time I carry the ball. I'm a workhorse, you know what I mean? I love when they give me the ball, and I just try to help my team win as much as I can.
Larry Fitzgerald is a great Heisman candidate. You think you should be getting some votes after this performance?
Nah, Larry Fitzgerald all the way. He's a manimal. He's a manimal. But I got great respect for them. They play hard, but hey, we played hard too.
Quincy, appreciate your time. Congratulations. Go celebrate.
Quincy was a manimal himself tonight. Congratulations to him, to the Mountaineers, and to those in authority here at West Virginia who have achieved their goal of keeping the celebration in the stands. And this is going to be quite a celebration in the stands and around Morgantown tonight as West Virginia thrusts itself right into the middle of the Big East race with a 52-31 win over the Pittsburgh Panthers in the 96th edition of the Backyard Brawl. Coming up next here on ESPN2, College Game Day Scoreboard with Matt Weiner. World Post Game on ESPN News. For Bill Curry, Rob Stone, our whole crew, Dave Barnett, so long from Morgantown, West Virginia.